Hello and welcome to this edition of For His Glory.
你好，欢迎收看天使电视，这是荣耀归于神的系列。
We've been talking about the bride of Christ and how the bride of Christ is separate from the body or other than the body of Christ.
那么我们一直在谈的就是基督的心腹，也就是说呢，我们作为基督的心腹呢，应该怎么样的分别为圣？
I've showed you in scripture last week how the bride comes forth from the body in Genesis, just as Eve came forth out of Adam.
那上个星期呢，我们已经从创世纪里面看到啊，就是亚当的心腹是如何从他的身体拿了一条肋骨出来造的。同样的，我们也会看到我们这个心腹是怎么形成的。
And then we were looking in Genesis 24 of how Abraham, who's a type of God the Father, sent Eliezer, his servant, which his name means helper and comforter, back to his family to get a bride for his son Isaac.
那接着呢，我们也从创世纪24章呢看到亚伯拉罕呢是预表了天父，而那个老仆人以利以谢呢是预表了圣灵。那么亚伯拉罕呢要求他的仆人怎么样回到他的本地本族去为他的儿子娶一个妻。
And not only is God trying to convey the fact that there is a difference between the body of Christ as a whole and the bride, but then we began to define some of the character of the bride based upon Genesis 24.
那不单指呢，神传达的信息是这个心腹和基督的肢体呢是不一样的，同时他也告诉我们，作为一个心腹，我们应该有怎么样的特质。
And I said define some of the character or some of the aspects of that make up the character because there's much more in the Word of God that we're not going to have time for even in weeks and weeks of study. But in this chapter, we're seeing her character as God is looking for that type of character.
当然作为一个基督的心腹呢，我们不只是只有一个的特质，不过呢，如果我们要讲的话，真的是几个星期几年都讲不完，所以呢，我们要特别的从创世纪24章里面来看一看这个心腹的特质。
And I talked about a Hebrew word yalak, which means to journey and to vanish.
那么我也谈到了希伯来文的一个字 yalak, 就是呢要进入一个荒芜之地的旅程。
And so we saw Abraham send his servant Eliezer, who's a type of helper or comforter, who journeyed and vanished back to Abraham's family to get this bride.
所以我们从经文看到呢，这个以利以谢，也就是亚伯拉罕的仆人呢，必须要经过这个荒芜的旅程，去到他的本族本家去，为他的儿子娶个妻子。
And he came with a test to qualify the bride.
那么他也设定了一个的试验呢，使到这个女子是能够经验得起，以至于能够成为以撒的心腹。
And this test was to see if she truly had a servant's heart.
那么这个的试验呢，是要看一看她是否真正有一个仆人的心智。
And so we'll pick it up again in verse 17 where he's just prayed and he sees a candidate come forth and he's excited that maybe God has made his way prosperous.
那么我们继续的来看24章的17节啊，就是当这个仆人一祷告完毕之后呢，哎，就有一个女子走出来了。
Verse 17 says, And the servant Eliezer ran to meet her and said, Please let me drink a little water from your pitcher.
那仆人以利以谢跑上前去啊，迎接他，然后呢，对他说：“请你将瓶里的水给我一点喝。”
Again, I've got to tell you that the well that she drew the water from in the Hebrew is pronounced latai roi, or the well of his presence.
那么这口井呢，在希伯来文的意思 latai roi 就是呢神同在的意思。
So we have a picture of the nourishing properties of the Word of God, the water of God's Word.
那所以呢，这口井呢就代表着神那丰盛的话语。
So in verse 18 it says, She said, Drink, my Lord, and then she quickly let her pitcher down from her shoulder and gave him a drink.
那十八节女子说，我主请喝，就急忙地拿下瓶来，托在手上给他喝。
And again to remind you, what she did was she recognized the voice of the Spirit of God. Why? Because in Hebrew culture in those days, she shouldn't have been talking to a strange man.
那我要你特别注意的是呢，就是这个女子啊，她意识到呢是神在对她说话。为什么我这样说呢？因为在当时候的时代的里面，是不适宜让一个女子和陌生人对话的。
And I've been using prophetic type and symbol to try and paint a picture for you of what God is doing here.
那么我也从先知性的角度讲了一些的预表，就是神到底在这幅的图画的里面要告诉我们一些的含义。
So if Eliezer is a type of the Holy Spirit, she's responding to the voice of the Spirit.
那以利以谢呢，就是预表了圣灵，所以这个女子呢，是对圣灵做出了回应。
Remember, we said last week, the test of a servant's heart is not if I ask you for a glass of water and you give me one.
那上个星期我们讲了，所谓的仆人的心智，并不是说我向你要求一杯水，你就给我一杯水。
That might just be proper upbringing.
这只是呢一个有教养的孩子的表现。
No, the servant's heart is initiated from somewhere inside, something that can't be seen that says, there's a need, I identify it, let me help.
那么仆人的心智呢，乃是一种很主动的心态，就是当他看到一个需要的时候，他会主动说，让我来帮忙吧。
Verse 19 says, when she had finished giving him a drink, she said, I will draw water for your camels also until they have finished drinking.
那么十九节这里说，女子给他喝了，就说：“我在为你的骆驼打水，叫骆驼也喝足。”
Again, camels don't drink just a little bit of water like your pet cat or your pet dog.
那再来注意了，骆驼呢所喝的水量是非常大的，不像你家里的那些的宠物，只是喝一小盘的水。
They had just crossed 780 miles of desert, and they're thirsty.
那他们涉足在沙漠上大概是70到80公里，所以这个时候非常的渴了。
And camels can drink from 180 to 360 gallons of water apiece.
那你知道啊，这个骆驼一次过呢可以喝180到360加仑的水。
Verse 20 says that she quickly emptied her pitcher into the trough, ran back to the well of his presence to draw water and drew for all the camels.
二十节说，他就急忙把瓶里的水倒在槽里，又跑到井旁打水，就为所有的骆驼打上水来。
Now notice in verse 18, she quickly gave him a drink, and here in verse 20, she quickly watered the camels and ran back to the well of his presence to draw forth water so that the camels would be satiated or filled.
那么十八节啊，我们注意到呢，他急忙地拿下瓶来呢，让这个老仆人能够喝水。二十节呢，又说到他急忙地把这个水倒在槽里面，然后呢，又跑到井旁啊，打水上来给所有的骆驼喝。
Verse 21 says, the man wondering at her remained silent so as to know whether the Lord had made his journey prosperous or not.
二十一节，那人定睛看他，一句话也不说，要晓得耶和华赐他通达的道路没有。
Now I find that very interesting, and it's very telling, and it gives us a clue even for our own lives.
那么我觉得这里的记载非常的有意思，而且呢，也给了我们一些的提示，我们的生命应该是怎么样的。
Remember, these camels were a test of servanthood.
那你知道了，就是借着这些的骆驼呢，来试验女子的仆人心智。
But on a deeper level, they're also a test of her character.
那从另外更深的角度来看呢，其实也是一个性格上的考验。
Let me give you a picture of how the Lord defined this for me.
那么让我给你一个的画面，就是神怎么样的来解释这个画面。
We all face tests in our life, and so I like to say the first camel she began to water was the camel of lack.
那我知道我们每个人的生命当中呢，都要经过一些的试验。那么她所遇到的第一只的骆驼呢，就是缺乏的骆驼。
So she went to the well of his presence, the word, and she drew forth Philippians 4:19, my God shall supply all of your needs according to his riches in glory, and she watered that camel.
于是呢，她就急忙地回到井旁去打水。这个水呢，就好像腓立比书4:19所说的，我的神必照他荣耀的丰富，在基督耶稣里使你们一切所需用的都充足。她就打起水来呢，回去给骆驼喝足了。
So she applied the water from the well of his presence, the word of God, until she overcame that test.
也就是说呢，她从神的同在的当中吸取了这个水，然后呢，以至于她能够经过这样的一个试验。
The next camel we can say is the camel of infirmity.
第二只骆驼呢，就是这个疾病上的缺乏。
And so she went back to the well of his presence and drew forth of 1 Peter 2:24, by his stripes you were healed, and she watered that camel till it could drink no more.
那么她又回到井旁，回到神的同在的当中，吸取什么呢？就是在彼得前书第二章二十四节的，就是她的鞭伤能够使到我们得医治，然后又给骆驼喝足了。
And so the test that was in her life,are the same tests each one of us face sometimes on a daily basis.
当然这个女子所经过的一切的考验呢也是我们在生活中每一天所要经历的考验。
But you see, because she drew daily from the well of his presence and knew where to get more water from the well of his presence, she applied it immediately to every test until she overcame.
那别忘了他是每一天都出来打水的也就是说呢他每一天都遇到神的同在以至于有问题发生的时候呢他立刻能够去到神的面前来支取足够的力量来面对他的考验
She wasn't weary in well doing and she didn't grow faint
他并没有慌张他并没有忧虑
Because it said she ran to the well and quickly ran and quickly ran and quickly
因为这边的图画让我们看到的是他急急忙忙地跑到井那边又跑回来跑到井那边又急忙地跑回来
And notice again that it was this man being silent to see if he was prosperous in what he came to do or Holy Spirit was quiet during the time of her testing
那么就在他经历这个考验的过程当中呢这个老仆人啊一句话也没有说只是定睛的看着他在经过那一些的考验
Have you ever noticed when you're facing a test that all of a sudden it seems that the heavens are brass and you just can't break through
那么你有没有这样的经历呢就是当你经过这个考验的时候好像神是静默不语的你没有办法突破
We don't seem to hear God as clearly we seem to be in a very dark place
我们经过考验的时候我们没有好像没听到神的声音好像在处在黑暗的里面
And most of us begin to think Oh no, I've made God mad I've missed God I'm in sin We begin to do this inward look to say What did I do wrong?
那么在经历考验的时候呢我们就会问神说到底我是不是做错了什么了我是不是在得罪你啊所以以至于我会经历这么难过的时期
When the truth of the matter is, many times, that you didn't do anything wrong, but Holy Spirit is testing your character.
那事实上呢，并不是你做错了什么，而是圣灵在那边考验你的个性。
You see, he was there with every expectation and every hope of seeing her overcome the test and become the bride of Christ.
你知道吗？老仆人就是在那边安静定睛地看希望他能够经过这一切的考验以至于他能够成为以撒的心腹
I want you to know the Lord does not allow any tests in your life that he's not already prepared you for in your inner man
我告诉你神不会让你经过任何的考验是你这个属灵人还没有预备好的
If you seem to be weak in faith then you need to run back to the well of his presence
要是你的信心软弱的话我们必须回到有神同在的水井旁
Remember, she poured out what she had and she ran back to this word, the well of his presence and got more and then used that
那你看到她的动作吗就是她把自己所有的水倒出来之后又回到水井那边重新的充满这个桶有这个水能够再次的倒出来
You know, while what I do for the Lord is important, what I become in the Lord is eternal.
那我为主做的一切是重要的但是我成为怎么样的一个人却是永恒的
God is trying to work something out in us.
你知道吗神要在我们的生命当中动工
He wants his character perfected in us.
他要他的性情在我们的里面得以完全
And as you study scripture, you'll find out that the character of the bride matches the character of the bridegroom or the Son of God.
那么如果我们来查考圣经的时候，我们看到原来新妇的特质和神的独生儿子，也就是那个新郎的特质呢，是一致的。
And so we see her watering these camels until they were satiated, they could drink no more.
那么她呢，就一直给他们倒水，直到骆驼喝足了。
Verse 22 says that it was when the camels had finished drinking, the man took a golden nose ring, and he took two bracelets for her wrists, weighing 10 shekels of gold, and he gave them to her.
22节骆驼喝足了，那人就拿一个金环，重半舍克勒，两个金镯，重10舍克勒，给了那女子。
So what happened?
这是怎么一回事呢？
She passed the test.
原来她经过了考验。
It was a test of character.
这是性格上的一个考验。
It was a test of perseverance.
这是一种恒久忍耐的考验。
And then we see the reward for that test having been complete.
所以当他经过了这个考验之后，他就得到了应得的奖赏。
In biblical type, gold speaks of holiness and purity in the fear of God.
那么在圣经里面呢，金呢，就是代表纯洁，代表一种的神圣。
So we have a picture here. He gave her a golden nose ring. Your nose speaks of your discernment.
那么这里呢，就是说到呢，给了他一个的金环。这个呢，金环就是说一个辨识的能力。
What he was doing here, what we're seeing, the picture that's coming forth is that wherever she was in her ability to discern, there was a purification of that in her life as she passed this test.
那就是呢。在他的生命的当中啊，由于他有这个辨识的能力，所以他能够知道什么东西是纯洁的，以至于他能够经过这个考验。
Your hands speak of your service.
你的双手说到你的服事。
As we already saw, she was a woman with a servant's heart.
那我们看到呢，这个女子是有着仆人的心智。
But these golden bracelets spoke of an advancement in her service. It became purer. It became more holy unto God because it came from a pure heart.
那么这个金环呢，就说到她的服饰是纯净的，她的服饰呢是圣洁的，因为呢是来自一颗纯洁的心。
I want you to know something. Anytime you face a test, it's for the purpose of promotion.
那我要告诉你的是，每一次你经历一个考验的时候，是要提升你的生命。
The Lord is not looking at you and hoping you fail or expecting you to fail.
神呢，并不是希望你在考验的当中失败或者是失脚了。
No, He's already given you His Word. He's given you His Holy Spirit. He's given you His wisdom. You have the mind of Christ. You have everything you need to overcome in any test.
因为呢，神已经把他的话语赐给你，把他的智慧赐给你，把圣灵赐给你，把一切赐给你，以至于你有能力来经历一切的考验。
And look what happens. He asks in verse 23, "Whose daughter are you? Tell me, please. Is there room in your father's house for us to lodge?"
23节说，请告诉我你是谁的女儿？你父亲家里有我们住宿的地方没有？
And she goes through her genealogy. Basically, she says, yes, I'm Abraham's niece.
那于是呢，她回到自己的家谱啊，就说我是亚伯拉罕的侄女。
And then she says in verse 25, she has room enough and straw enough to feed them and to lodge them.
然后呢，她又说我们家里足有这个粮草，也有住宿的地方。
And it says in verse 26, something very interesting. It says the man bowed his head and worshipped God.
那么二十六节，那个人就低头向耶和华下拜。
I want you to think about this for a minute.
那让我们在这里停一停，来思想一下。
What does it look like in the natural realm when Holy Spirit bows his head in worship?
那么如果在自然的眼光的里面呢，当这个圣灵低下头敬拜的时候，是怎么样的一幅图画呢？
Is it possible that we're seeing some of that take place in the earth today with this new sound that's coming forth in worship?
那你有没有在这个自然界的里面，就是当我们在敬拜的时候，有一个新的声音发出来呢？
Well, what happens is Rebecca runs back to her family, tells her brother Laban what happened, and Laban came out to invite this man back to the house.
那于是呢，女子啊就赶快回家去，把所发生的一切呢告诉拉班，拉班就跑出来看看发生什么事。
And so when Eliezer gets to the house, he goes through the whole story and the process they went through and shares that with the family.
那么当以利以谢来到利百家的时候呢，就把事情的经过一五一十的告诉他的家人。
Verse 49 says, Now if you will deal kindly and truly with my master, tell me, and if not, tell me that I may turn to the right hand or to the left. And Laban and Bethel answered and said, The thing comes from the Lord. We cannot speak to you either bad or good.
24章49节，现在你们若愿以慈爱诚实待我主人，就告诉我，若不然也告诉我，使我可以或向左或向右。拉班和比士利回答说，这事乃出于耶和华，我们不能向你说好说歹。
They go on to say, here's Rebecca, take her and let her journey and vanish with you and be your master's son's wife.
那么接着他就说呢，既然是这样的话，就让利百加成为你的主人的儿子的妻子吧。然后呢，他们就往回城去了。
Then Eliezer takes out jewelry of silver, jewelry of gold and clothing and gives it to Rebecca.
那么这个时候呢，以利以谢就把带来的这些金啊、银啊、还有衣服啊、财物呢，都给了利百加。
I want you to think about that. Silver speaks of sanctification and redemption. Gold is holiness, purity, and the fear of God.
那让你想一想的是，金呢是代表了神的圣洁，还有纯净，而银呢是说到我们在神的面前被炼净。
Clothing can speak of mantles.
那么这个衣服呢，就是代表着一个师傅的全能来包围着这个人。
And then we see in verse 61 that Rebecca and her maids arose and rode on the camels and followed the man. So the servant took Rebecca and they journeyed and vanished.
那么六十一节这里说，利百加和他的使女们起来，骑上骆驼，跟着那仆人，仆人就带着利百加走了。他们就是走向另外一条的荒芜之地。
So those things that were the tests in her life actually became the means or mode of transportation that brought her beside her beloved, the one that she loved.
所以我们看到她的性情呢，带领着她呢，能够走向她心爱的人的那个方向去。
I hope you see that when tests come into your life, it's the very mode or means of transportation that brings intimacy between you and God.
我要你看到的是，所有的考验就好像是一个的通道，让我们能够走到与神建立亲密关系的地步。
Father, bless your people with hungry hearts.
天父啊，祝福你的子民，让他们有饥渴慕义之心。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名。
Amen.
Amen.
Remember to do all things for His glory.
记得了，我们所做的一切。都要将荣耀归给神。
Stairs of light, angels bright, and the night. in glory, joyfully lovingly lead me to his garden, to paradise on high. My spirit longs to fly to the brilliance of his glory and his light. Jesus, you're my heart's desire. I long to see your sweet face and run to your loving embrace, my Jesus, lover of my soul. Jesus, you're my heart's desire, and I will wait for you here in the midst of your garden of love, and worship till you come unto me. Cinnamon, frankincense, calamus, sweet aloes, beautiful tree of life, center of this temple. I feel strong, full of life, youthfulness and pure joy. Gentle breeze, garden walls, tall white marble columns, garden in paradise. My spirit longs to fly as angels of his presence now open up the gate. Jesus enters paradise in all his splendor and grace. The light rays and beams from his face, gazes with eyes of liquid blue love. Stunned by love as I'm crying out, Son of God, Jesus, shining bright with your light, bright diamond sparkle and shine in a rainbow. My true love, garden in paradise.